Hey guys, welcome back to this 100-day challenge for DevOps and Cloud. And today is day 11. Today we are going to talk about 11 different tools related to container orchestration. And also we will try to understand quickly how these tools are different and where it can be suitable for us, so we can take the better decision for our organization while choosing the correct container orchestration tool. It can be your Kubernetes, it can be your OpenShift, it can be Nomad, it can be Ransom. So let's see which tool is suitable for us and what tools we want to use it. So let's start without wasting time. So guys, so let's understand these tools one by one. So first tool we are having, Kubernetes. As you know, it's an open source and it helps to manage many containers in a smart way. So that's why it's useful for managing containerized application at larger scale. So if we define Kubernetes, it's an open source container orchestration platform that automates containers deployment, scaling, and management. So the unique feature of this Kubernetes is it's like the captain of a ship, making sure that all the containers work together smoothly. It's super popular nowadays, you know, and can run on different cloud services as well. And it's the most adopted container orchestration platform in the market. Let's talk about next tool, that is Docker Swarm tool. It's an open source and it's ideal for small to medium sized Docker deployments. So it makes handling a small group of containers very easy. You can understand it's like a friendly group leader, which is great for a small container gathering. So Docker Swarm is a native Docker clustering and orchestration solution that provides simple container management. Now let's talk about the third tools from the list. So that is Apache Mesos, that also an open source, and it's a distributed system kernel that abstract computer resources, making it suitable for building distributed systems. So it's well suited for large scale resource efficient systems. So it helps actually in big systems to share their resources in better way. So it's mainly useful for better resource utilization, and it's like a super resource manager, which makes sure that computers share their power wisely, and it can even work with different applications together. So it's one of the best tools we are having along with Kubernetes. Now let's talk about the next tool, that is Amazon EKS, that is Elastic Kubernetes Service from Amazon. And it's a managed service. What is the difference between managed service and open source? Like, open source is available for all and you can utilize the same code, modify it, and you can use it according to yourself. When we are talking about the managed services, it's a responsibility of cloud service provider to manage all the infrastructure related to these services, and you just need to use that service and pay for the utilization you are doing. So it's a makes running containers on Amazon's cloud, so it's a perfect for deploying Kubernetes workload on AWS. So EKS is a managed Kubernetes service which provides by AWS, which I already mentioned, and it's simplifying Kubernetes deployment on the AWS platform. Next service we are having, Google GKE, that is Google Kubernetes Engine. It actually helps to run containers smoothly on Google Cloud. It's again a managed service. So whatever cloud is providing, they are providing managed services. So infrastructure they are taking care, you just need to use that services for your Kubernetes workload. So GKE is a managed Kubernetes service by Google Cloud, which offers Kubernetes deployment and integration with Google services. So it's excellent for Kubernetes user on Google Cloud. Similarly, if we talk about the Azure Kubernetes service, is known as AKS. It's also a managed service, and it's a managed Kubernetes service on Azure Cloud, which streamlines Kubernetes management on Azure Cloud platform. So the purpose of this service is to make running containers easy on Microsoft Cloud. So it's like a wizard for your containers on Azure, simplifying their management and scaling. So it's great for Kubernetes deployment in the Azure ecosystem. As you know, if you are running Microsoft services in your organization, that it's really an easy way to run Kubernetes deployment on Azure Cloud for you because of smooth integration. Now let's talk about next tool, that is OpenShift. available like open source and commercial. So it's a Kubernetes based container platform which is provided by Red Hat, and it offers additional features and tools for containerized application deployment and development. So it's normally suitable for organizations with Red Hat technology or seeking an enterprise grade solution. So if you are looking for Red Hat technology related Kubernetes system, then OpenShift is a great choice for you. And the unique feature of this is it helps create and manage containers with extra features, and it's like a Swiss Army knife for containers, which offers lots of tools for developers, especially in larger organizations. Now let's talk about next tool, that is Nomad. Nomad is an open source tool, and it schedules and manages different types of tasks. So Nomad is a open source workload orchestrator by HashiCorp. So we are having Terraform from HashiCorp, right? Similarly, we are having Nomad as a Kubernetes, or we can say container orchestration tool from HashiCorp that schedules containers, virtual machines, and applications. So it's like a flexible task planner which handles not only containers but also your virtual machines and applications. So if you are have mixed kind of environment like virtual machines, applications, or container, then Nomad can be a very useful tool for you and for your environment with diverse workload to orchestrate. Now let's talk about next tool, that is tool number 9, that is Rancher. It's available as a open source and commercial like OpenShift, and it's provide an easy way to manage Kubernetes and Docker all together. So Rancher is a open source container management platform with a user friendly interface for Kubernetes and Docker management, and it's good for organizations looking for simplified Kubernetes and Docker management. If you want to manage both the things like Kubernetes and Docker, then Rancher is a great choice for you. Now let's talk about next tool, that is Containerd. So Containerd is an industry standard container runtime. It's not a complete container orchestration platform, but it's a foundational component in container orchestration platform. So it's available open source, and it fits as a container runtime in container orchestration solutions. So it's like a silent worker, we can say, behind the scenes, making sure containers run smoothly without lots of extra features. And also it takes care of basics of containers which are running on our platform. Now let's talk about next tool, that is Portainer. That is the last tool from the list, and it's offer a simple and friendly interface for Docker. It's available as a open source and commercial. It's available for free as well. So Portainer is a user-friendly container management platform that simplified Docker container management with a graphical user interface. So it's available as a GUI. So if you are not comfortable with the command line interface, then you can use this tool and you can run your containers as well and manage efficiently. It's ideal for organizations and users who is looking for an easy to use Docker management tools. So the thing is, we have seen 11 different tools, but these tools has its own special features and uses. So on the basis of these uses, you can define your use case. So understand first your environment, which tool is suitable for you. Accordingly, you can use that tool. It's not like if you want to manage everything and you just going with the Kubernetes. If you are, as we already seen, that for that one, we have a tool called Nomad, which can do everything. Like it can manage your containers, manage your virtual machine, manage your application. So each tool has their own unique feature, right? Just go through them, explore more so for better understanding, and also mention in the comment section which tools I need to cover in detail. Normally we are going to cover Kubernetes definitely, but if you want other tools, just let me know in the comment section. Now it's time for you to support me. Just like this video, share with your friends, subscribe this channel for more learning content. See you tomorrow with new concept related to container orchestration.